Jesus is the Messiah. Therefore, we should rejoice and draw near to him. Christmas is a wonderful time of year, isn't it? I mean, many of us would say that it's our favorite time of year. We love the traditions, we love the decorations, but most of all, we love what it celebrates. That the Lord Jesus Christ came to earth in order to redeem us from our sins. In this week's Sunday School lesson, we're taking a break from our walk through the Bible to focus especially on the birth of the Messiah and its implications for our lives as we study Matthew chapters 1 and 2. First, let's talk a little bit about the Gospel of Matthew itself. Matthew is a gospel written by a Jew to Jews about a Jew who was the king of the Jews. Pretty cool, huh? And one of Matthew's goals in writing this was to demonstrate that Jesus was the promised Messiah. In chapter 1 of his gospel, Matthew gives us two reasons why we should believe that. The first reason Matthew gives us comes in the form of a genealogy. Way back in Genesis chapter 12, God had promised that through the family of Abraham, all of the families of the earth would be blessed. In Genesis 49, God used the blessing of Jacob, Abraham's descendant. He used the blessing of Jacob upon his sons to predict that the scepter, the symbol of kingship, would not depart from Judah. In 2 Samuel chapter 7, God made a covenant with David, promising that the Messiah would come from the lineage of David and that his kingdom would endure forever. In this genealogy, Matthew explains that Jesus came from the line of Abraham through Judah and from the house of David. Without question, he had the foretold pedigree of the Messiah. Another reason Matthew gives for believing in Jesus as the promised Messiah is the fulfillment of a promise, namely that Jesus Christ was born of a virgin. In the Old Testament, the prophet Isaiah had foretold that a virgin, a woman that had never been in a situation where she could become pregnant, that a virgin would bear a son, and that his name would be called Emmanuel. Well, in the New Testament, we're told that an angel appeared to Mary and told her that the Holy Spirit would come upon her and that she would give birth to the Son of God. Mary hadn't yet been with Joseph, her betrothed, when the Holy Spirit placed Jesus inside of her. Jesus was the prophesied Emmanuel, God with us, the fulfillment of Isaiah's messianic prophecy. So Matthew gives us two reasons why we should believe that Jesus is the Messiah. But he also provides us with an example that demonstrates how we should respond to the Messiah. It's the example of Joseph. It had become clear that Mary was pregnant, and because Joseph didn't know that Mary's pregnancy was a miracle, he decided that he would quietly divorce her. But God sent an angel to Joseph in a dream who told Joseph not to be afraid to take Mary as his wife because the child conceived in her was of the Holy Spirit. She hadn't been unfaithful to him. No, instead, she had been chosen for an honor. She would give birth to the long-awaited Messiah. And in response to the incredible news about the coming Messiah, Joseph chose to follow the angel's direction. Joseph and Mary were wed. And just a short time later, in a Bethlehem stable, Mary gave birth to Jesus, the long-awaited Messiah. And because Joseph was willing to believe God, he received the incredible opportunity to serve as Jesus' adoptive father. In Matthew chapter 2, we're also told about a very special visit paid to Jesus by a group of men known as Magi, who came to worship Jesus because they had seen his star in the east. It's a fascinating story. And let me point out a couple of things about the Magi. First, they didn't arrive on the night that Jesus was born. Jesus was at least several months old at the time of their visit, and possibly as old as 2. We also don't know how many Magi there were. We know that there were at least 2 because they're described using a plural noun, so that means that there was more than one, but there may have been many more than that. And we should note that the Magi were not kings, as the popular Christmas song suggests. No, the term Magi was used to refer to men of learning who often studied mystical and religious matters. And even though the scriptures never tell us to search the skies for signs of God's activity, God showed grace to these men and used a star to alert them to the birth of the one they called the King of the Jews, so that they might travel to Bethlehem with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and offer him their worship. Jesus is the Messiah. Therefore, we should rejoice and draw near to him. So what lessons should we learn from these great chapters of Scripture? Well, these chapters reveal God's faithfulness to his promises. The birth of Christ fulfilled God's redemptive promises made centuries and millennia earlier. Jesus came to be the prophesied Emmanuel, God with us. He was the one who would make salvation available not only to his own people, but to all people, including us. And that's reason to rejoice. We ought to praise God for being faithful to his promises, for providing salvation through Christ. This truth should also motivate us to draw near to Jesus. That's what Joseph did. When he learned that he could have a close relationship with the Messiah, Joseph changed his plans. Instead of quietly divorcing Mary as he had planned, he took Mary as his wife. He chose to be the earthly father of the one who would rescue him from his sins. Joseph chose to be used by God in that way. And not only did Joseph draw near to Jesus, but that's also what the Magi did. After receiving the sign of Christ's birth, these men, they left their homes and their families to travel hundreds of miles away, bringing costly gifts to worship Jesus. And boys and girls, moms and dads, if there's never been a definite point in your life when you've chosen to draw near to Jesus by asking him to forgive you of your sins and to be the Lord of your life, then I want to encourage you to do that right away. There's no more important decision that you will ever make. For those of you that have already trusted Christ, well, I need to ask if you're serious about drawing near to Jesus. Are you spending time with him in prayer and Bible study? Are you choosing to deny yourself, to take up your cross daily, putting to death your desire to serve yourself so that you can follow Jesus? I want to challenge you to do that for your own good and for the glory of God. Jesus is the Messiah. Therefore, we should rejoice and draw near to him. Let's pray and ask God to help us respond to these wonderful truths in the way that would honor him. Heavenly Father, we praise you for these incredible chapters of Scripture, which revealed that you fulfilled your promises made centuries earlier. You promised that you would send a Messiah who would be Emmanuel, God with us. And then your Son came as the fulfillment of that promise. He dwelt among a sinful people, Lord, in order that he might live a perfect, sinless life, performing miracle after miracle that proved that not only was he the Messiah, but that he was God in human flesh. And Lord, we're told that for anyone who chooses to place their faith in Jesus, we can have our sins forgiven because Jesus not only came to live that perfect sinless life, but he was willing to sacrifice that life as a payment for our sin and so that all who would believe in him might know eternal life through faith in him. Lord, we praise you for what Jesus did for us. We praise you for the truths that we celebrate at Christmas time. And my prayer for any boy or girl or mom or dad who has never chosen to embrace Jesus personally would do so as a result of studying these wonderful Christmas truths. For the rest of us that have already trusted Christ, Lord, would you help us to draw near to him, choosing to develop our relationship with Jesus as Joseph did, choosing to draw near in worship to Jesus as the Magi did. Lord, would our lives be characterized by that kind of devotion and love for Christ? We pray all of these things in the wonderful name of your Son, Jesus. Amen. Well, that's all for this video. Praise the Lord for these wonderful Christmas truths. I hope that you and your family have a great celebration of the Christmas holiday. And until next time, keep pleasing the Lord.